Welcome to Down to the River with Pastor Adam from Oglesby Union Church. Down to the River is a fast 5 minutes to drink in some of the living water given to us by Jesus through studying His Word, the Bible. From Oglesby Union Church, here's Pastor Adam.
Down at the church, we've been walking through the life of Jesus again, but this time through the account given to us by Luke. Luke gives us a lot of details about Jesus. 2 weeks ago, we looked at a scene in Jesus' life that was a step-by-step through His day. Where He worshiped, where He ate after the service was over, who He was with, what He did before He got His meal, what happened in the afternoon and evening, and even how He slipped away from everyone in the early hours of the next morning to have some alone time and reset where He was going next. Now, this is Luke's purpose for his readers, and especially for a man named Theophilus, who Luke names in the first chapter. Quote, "It always seemed good to me, since I have carefully investigated everything from the very first, to write to you in an orderly sequence, most honorable Theophilus, so that you may know the certainty of the things about which you have been instructed." Unquote. Luke gives us some standalone events that allow us in on conversations that Jesus has with one other person. And this last week, the conversation was between Jesus and Simon, or better known as Peter, or his Aramaic name, Cephas. Now, this is the third time that Jesus has come in contact with him, and he finds Simon at the seashore after a night of fishing in which he and his crew have caught nothing. Simon was cleaning, or straightening up and repairing his nets for the next night of fishing. Now, Jesus shows up with a crowd, listening to his every word, and then Jesus asks Simon to use his boat to float out from shore to continue to speak to the multitude. Simon obeys and probably continues on with his task of preparing the nets from the boat while Jesus is teaching. We call this multitasking. Jesus then ends his sermon. He says, "Amen," and he turns his eyes from the multitude on the shore and fixes them on the one person, Simon, the owner of the boat. And he asks a second request. The first was to push out from shore. The second was to put out his neatly repaired stacked nets for the next night's fishing now. And it was the wrong time to fish, and it was time to go home and get something to eat and fall asleep after fishing all night. But Simon reluctantly obeys. He puts out his nets, and the catch of fish is so great that his nets begin to tear. He calls for help to the other fishermen, and they bring their boats, but their boats aren't even large enough to hold all the fish in the nets. And now Simon turns his eyes from the multitude of the fish in the nets and the boats and fixes them on one person, Jesus. Now, when you come in contact with greatness, you recognize your smallness, and the natural response is to step back or push away because you think that they would not want you around them. Simon said to Jesus, "Go away from me because I'm a sinful man, Lord." He thought Jesus wouldn't want him because of who he was, but Simon was wrong. Jesus responded back to him, "Don't be afraid. From now on, you'll be catching people." Here's the point. If you are pushing Jesus away, then know that He wants you and is stepping in even closer because He has something to do through you for the sake of others. And we would see this fulfilled in Simon's life when he cast his net of the gospel on the day of Pentecost and 3,000 souls were saved, caught that day. Friend, join us this morning as we walk through this book and through the life of Jesus. This Sunday, we have Jesus face to face with a man with a skin disease that has been living in a separated life from his family because of its infection. See how Jesus deals with the unwanted of society. I would also invite you to join us in prayer for the congregants of the Sutherland Springs First Baptist Church as they move forward after a tragic Sunday last week. Remember that evil is lessened in our society by the abundance of good acted upon and taught in our homes, churches, and schools. Men, join us this Saturday for our monthly men's breakfast at the church at 7:30 a.m. It's a great way to start the day. And I'm Pastor Adam. I invite you to join us this morning at 10:15 for another message from God's Word, the Bible, and check out our website at ouc.life. And may you receive the blessings of God as you live your life to the glory of Him.
Join Pastor Adam this morning at Oglesby Union Church. They're right next to City Hall on Walnut Street. And their Sunday morning worship service starts at 10:15. Oglesby Union Church's mission is to know Jesus, grow in Him, go where He leads, and show His love. Drink more of the living water from Jesus today at Oglesby Union Church, and go down to the river again next Sunday morning at 8:25 on Classic Hits 103.9 WLPL.